Hi, this is Chandra. Today we are going to learn how to configure database mail in the SQL Server. So first I will connect the my local SQL Server using the SA account. Now I will go to the management areas and then here we can see the database mail. So I right click on that database mail and then click on the configure database mail. So one database mail configuration wizard came. So using that wizard we are configured the database mail. I will click on the next, then I will select the first option. It's by default selected the first option, so that's mean set up the database mail by performing the following tasks. First you need to create the email profile, then you need to specify under that email profile SMTP accounts. So I will click on next. Then I will give the profile name. So that profile name, anything you can give, and description also anything you can give. So now I am not putting the description. I will only give the profile name. Please remember that profile name is the most important, because when you are going to send mail, that you need to use that profile. I will give the profile name is the DB mail. I am going to add the SMTP account. So I will click add here. So then using that dbmail account, so I need to set up the SMTP account. So I will click here new account, then I will put the account name, put the Gmail, then I will skip the description. So I will put the email address. So I have already written the my email address, so I will put here. So I will give the display name. So now what is the display name? Display name, if we are check the Gmail account, that first come with one name, and after that we can see the all email address and other informations. So that is the display name. So I will put the display name for mail. So then I will put the reply email. If you want to put, you can. If you don't want to any reply to that mail, so please don't put it. So I will give the server name. So now I am configuring the SMTP account for the Gmail address. So now I need to put the Gmail SMTP address. So I put the smtp.gmail.com. I need to find out the port number for the that SMTP .gmail.com. So if I search here, so Gmail SMTP port number, so there is the two port number. One port number is 465, it's used for TLS, and another is 587, used for SSL. So here there are no TLS settings, so only SSL settings are there. So I will click on the SSL settings here, because when it will be authenticated, then it will be connected via the SSL. So I will put the port number 587. Yeah, 587. Now I need to give the authentication, SMTP authentication. So I will click basic authentication, and I will put my email address and the password, and the confirm password. Now I will click the OK. Now I will click the next. I will mark as that profile is public. So if you want to make a default profile, then you select the yes, or if you don't want, then you put just no. So I want that profile will be my default profile, then I will select the yes. So in the private profile settings, you can specify the username and who's in login into the background and send the mail. So I am not going to touch there. So I will click the next. So here there is the couple of settings you can specify. So first I will check the prohibited attested file extension. So sometime we need to send some files with the mail attachment as a mail attachment, so there is some extension we can prevent to send the attachment. So here is the by default there is some extension .exe, .dll, .vbs, .js. So that file will not attested as a attachment. So now I will click the next, and here is the summaries which action are going to perform now. So I will click on finish. So now I can see the successful message. So that's mean my profile successfully set up. So now I need to remember the DB mail. So because when we are going to send the mail, then we need to use the DB mail. So I'll close that one. Now I can test that mail configured successfully or not. So I'll right click on the database mail, send test email. So I'll put the one email address. Right, and send test mail and click on OK. So I'll go my Gmail account to check that mail arrived or not. So now you see now here display name for mail. So if I click there, so this is the test mail sent from the database mail on the computer number. So that's mean my database mail is successfully configured. That's it for today. So please subscribe my channel to get the more videos.